Let's begin by learning the parts of the microscope. First, the eyepiece is the tube that connects the ocular lens to the head of the microscope. Attached to the head is the nosepiece, which holds at least one objective lens. Below the objective lens or lenses is the stage, which is where the slide will rest. Stage clips hold the slide in place as you observe. The stage has a hole in it. The size and shape of the hole is controlled by the iris diaphragm. This hole allows light from the illuminator, which may be an electrical light or a mirror, to travel up through the iris diaphragm, through the slide, through the objective lens, through the eyepiece, and finally through the ocular lens to your eye. The bottom of the microscope is called the base. Always place the microscope base on a firm, steady, flat surface. Whenever the microscope is moved or carried, it should always be held by the arm in the base, like this. Microscopes help you see things that are too small for you to see with the unaided eye. However, a microscope is different from a magnifying glass. Slides are necessary when you use a microscope. Slides are small slips of glass or plastic. They are delicate and easily broken, especially glass slides. To see anything smaller than we can see with our eyes, or to see microscopic details on visible objects, we apply these items to a slide and place them between the illuminator and the lenses so that we can take a closer look. To create a slide to view with the microscope, begin with a clean slide and cover slip, or a second slide. Handle the slide by the edges to avoid placing fingerprints on the surface. Use a swab to collect the substance you want to view and wipe it on the slide carefully. When you are finished, place a cover slip or second slide over the area of the slide you touched with the swab. Handle this by the edges to avoid fingerprints here as well. Use the coarse focus knob to adjust the stage all the way down, as far away from the objective lens as it can move. Clip the slide onto the stage using the stage clips and make sure the area of the slide you want to observe is over the iris diaphragm. Rotate the nose piece until the objective lens you want to use is directly over the slide. The lowest magnification lens is often used when you begin to view a new slide. Using the coarse adjustment knob, bring the stage and slide up close to the objective lens. Now, look through the slide. Slowly rotate the coarse adjustment knob so that the stage moves down and away from the objective lens. If anything comes into the field of vision through the eyepiece, stop rotating the coarse adjustment knob. Begin using the fine adjustment knob instead, moving the stage toward or away from the lens as necessary to bring the image into clear focus. If you are unable to find any image with the microscope after adjusting the coarse focus knob, move the slide on the stage to focus on a different section of the prepared slide. The image you see is magnified or enlarged by the microscope twice. The ocular lens magnifies the image 10 times larger than life-sized. Objective lenses magnify the image also. Objective lenses have a number on the outside of the lens that indicates how much magnification they provide. The magnification of the lens is also called the power of the lens. To find out how much larger than life you are viewing the objects on a slide, a little simple math is required. Use the magnification of the ocular lens and the magnification of the objective lens you are using as factors in a multiplication problem. Multiply the power of the ocular lens times the power of the objective lens. The answer, or product, you get is the total magnification of the image. In this case, any image you see through the microscope would be 40 times larger than the actual object on the slide.